Hold on. Got it. How's it going? Na potato skills here. So when I went on shuffle, it was very very fortunate that we got this first. Miscellaneous meat, melons, potatoes. Oh yeah, the loot from my adventure. Completely forgot. Dark oak fence go downstairs. Where the heck does bread go? Over here? Help. Leather. Yeah, I'm guessing ladders and other wood items go downstairs. That stone wood goes over here. See, wood planks, wood slabs, wood stairs, wood fences. Planks. Don't know where ladders go, but they go somewhere. Explorer map that goes to the observatory. Oh wait. Soul torch. That's where those go. Found a place for the soul torches finally. Let's go. Okay. My elytra has seen better days. Oh yeah, I figured out what was wrong with my string duper. It needs to face north. Not that I need a string duper anymore, because I have a full sheep farm, but you know. Cats should not be able to spawn in here because there should be no ground for them to spawn on. Anyway, I do need to restock on glass, actually. You have glass. Glass. And glass. All right, we're good. Yeah, I have to say, I'm very excited for Brutal Mode this Wednesday. I don't know. I'm just excited. It's gonna be an interesting one, you know? Paper. That's right, I need more. Light blue stained glass. I may need even more. Oh wait, I need to grab my one piece of soul sand. One piece of it, please. There we go. I remember from somewhere that you can use kelp to make source blocks. I've never done it before, though. Never successfully, anyway. But yeah. We're rocking the Halloween skin. And here we go. They did this not above the lava pool. Drop one. There we go. Look at that. And we're back. So, actually, I kind of like this approach. That is soft touch. Yeah, this is gonna take a while. Higher do we have to go? Still got a ways to go. Actually, is this good? We're at 129, so grab some nether brick, actually. Honestly, like, pretty perfect. How much does this hurt? I'm still alive. They didn't see that other set of rockets. Alright, let's go mining, I guess. Trouble. Here we go. We are. Perfect. This is sub-touch. We need our fortune pickaxe. Put our sub-touch tools away for now. Get to a good spot then. About here seems good. Outright. Hello, pig. All the blocks. You know, I don't know where I got my initial like of pigs from. It was before I started playing Minecraft, but I don't remember when. I had to get it from somewhere. Although I have never said that pigs are my favorite animal, they're like number two, right next to cats. Pigs are just fun, and funny. Might be from like the local pig races, like the fair they do every year. I don't even go to the fair anymore, but that might have been where my love for pigs started. That could have been it. That doesn't sound unplausible. Unplausible? Is that a word? Thank you. how much progress we're making. My shovel is going to die. Let me go so fast. Thank you. There we go. Get a lot of iron. Yeah, we need to head back. How is there still more stone cobble just like appearing? Are so damaged. The side path is just very plot convenient. Flint. This is just dirt and cobble. Yeah. know, it's crazy how little I care that I don't have to list. You only get one shot with the four beacons, really. See, it lines up perfectly, too. Having the five effects in the top right, it just looks nice. So, the city's coming along. It's coming along. I think I can actually get started on the Colosseum before the end of the year. Because we have the beacon, we can mine parts of it super fast. So we can actually get started on it. Which means I'm going to need to do some math. And some deforestation. Honestly, we probably need like 12 stacks because we just need more. There was something I was going to mention. Next year on the jukebox. This is very ambitious, but I do want to try and do double uploads. Very ambitious, especially considering I haven't even done this week's song yet. But the reason why is a surprise for not next year, but the year after that. But we'll get there when we get there. Really, though, December is going to be the test. It's going to be double upload December. I'm going to do 10 songs, Tuesdays and Thursdays. I hope it works out. I might actually do Tuesday, Friday instead, because that gives me Thursday to work on the song, which might be better. Tuesday, Friday actually sounds better, because then I have the weekend to work on the first song, and then I get Thursday to work on the second one. Most of the work is the picture. I also need to do the after hours loop. I need to do one of those this week. I'm behind on schedule on that. I'm supposed to do that every other week, but I've not been doing that. I've been slacking. One of the after hours that's going to be during December is going to be Breath of Winter. I don't know what the other one's going to be yet, though. I think I already did Shiver Star. Did I do Shiver Star? I might not have done it. No, I haven't, because the only Volume 1 songs I've done, I think, are Tribute and Carefree Day. Which means I also need to do Cattail 22. That's going to be an interesting pick. This song is also going to get uploaded. This one's probably going to be... December would be my guess for this one. That's right, I was probably going to end the year with this one. Nice bookend with the other one. The start of the year being this song, but not extended. In the Way was going to be next week, not this week. The extended version of In the Way. Actually running behind on Volume 3 songs. I'm almost done with the album. I need to make 3 more, I think. Let's see. Yeah, I need to make 3 more for Volume 3. And then that one's done. And I want Volume 3 to be fully out by the end of the year, which means not only do I need to make these 3 songs, but I also need to upload all the songs by the end of the year. Which is why I'm probably going to get 3 in November, or at least getting 2. I should need to look at, like, the calendar. Hold on. November, how many Tuesdays we got? We got 4. Okay. So... okay, we got 9 days in December, and we got 4 in November. So let's do some math. I'm going to go through the Volume 3 songs to see what I still need to do. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think 11, but it might be 10. So, we got, So including the Fridays, we only got 15. So Volume 3 is not going to be out by the end of the year. But it will be out by the end of June. That kind of actually is messing me up because... Okay. Yeah, I was going to upload one on January 1st as well. I think that was the plan. We'll see. But, yeah. Volume 3 is coming along pretty great. Big fan of it so far. So, we'll see what we've got. We'll see what we got going forward. But, yeah, I just imagine Volume 3 is going to take a bit. Volume 4, excited to work on it. There's always one song in each volume that I just don't want to work on, and I leave it till last. And this time it's Prismatic Factory. I just did not want to work on it, so I haven't for like the entire year, basically. Like, I started it, but then I hate how it sounds, so I need to, like, redo it completely. And it's not good. Touch, and that's Silk Touch. Actually, I don't need the Fortune one anymore, so Silk Touch one is better to keep. Anyway. Now, some people may be wondering, why the heck does this song not have its album cover? The media player is funky. That's why. I've tried updating it. I literally tried updating it earlier today, but it was just like, nah, suffer. So, anybody wondering why that's the case, there's your answer. Sucks because I like the album cover for this one a lot more than some of the other ones. But, you know, Divinity and God the Champion, you know, there, sort of the turn of space, just nah, just gonna be lazy. Makes me upset. I haven't added new album covers for some, or new album cover for some songs, which you might see. Like, it's three songs. Is it three or four? Yeah, it's three songs. So, like... Oh, wait, I needed to... I did need the, and we're back. Actually need the fortune shovel. I just forgot to get this last stuff. Did it go? Hmm. Whenever I hear this one, I always think it's 2023's, but it's just not. Got it. More dirt. Just so much of it. This was one of the songs I wanted to upload, but I just this is probably going to be a December upload. I actually need to like schedule out the songs that I want to upload. I need to actually do that. I did that for September and it really worked out pretty well. Kind of. There's one song I just didn't get to upload as a bonus, but I'll call it a reserve. Like, it wouldn't be a hard song to upload. It would just, it's a song I just want to keep in reserves for now. But like when I'm feeling real tired, just don't want to, don't have to do anything extra. It's my get out of jail free card. So tall. I don't remember why I chose the arbitrary elevation I did, but I did. I sure did. It's not even the same elevation as like the statue, but whatever. Did it like sync to the music there for a second? Hold on. I'm like getting dizzy. I'm making myself dizzy. This is probably awful to watch. That sounds really satisfying, though. Lightning is just like, yeah, no, I want to strike like right now. Thunderstorm into lightning strike in less than like 20 seconds. Less than like 5 seconds, honestly. You know, imagine you're like mining and somehow your diamonds are exposed to air. So you mine them and the diamonds fall and then the lightning immediately strikes them. That's comedy. Close to the beacon. I don't think lightning can break beacons, though, so... Hey, call center. Didn't even have to look for that one. One of the most like thunder heavy thunderstorms or lightning heavy thunderstorms that I've ever had. Just keeps striking everywhere. Oh, thunderstorm's over. Thank you. run out of space again. Plot convenience is real. Actually, just to be safe. We could just head back, unload all our stuff again. We're gonna need more chests. We're gonna need a lot more chests. Back. Yeah. Oh, right, we need wood. There's wood down the downstairs part, actually. I keep getting it mixed up. I almost stabbed my eye with my fingernail. That was a bad idea. I forgot some dirt. That's great. Fantastic. Exactly what I wanted for Christmas. Now I need to go all the way back down and take the dirt back and yada yada yada. Yeah, annoying. Whatever. Actually, I can wait. Because I need to go down anyway, because I was going to do something else. Back. to go until the end of this song. Oh, right. I was going to have a water break. I just had, like, a really random thought, but, like, why is the grammatically correct form of, saying, you know, gay people, but then you can just, the grammatically correct form for lesbians is just lesbians? I just thought of that randomly, like, why is that how it works? English is weird, man. Both deserve rights, then. But, like, why is that, like, a grammatical thing? I guess it's because one of those words has existed in language for longer, would be my guess. I was gonna go till the end of the other song. I'm dumb. Whoops. Say she'll be like full. I'm actually kind of disappointed. I don't even need the storage box, all that. Actually, I actually do want to make sure I haven't dropped any frames, though. No, I have not. I can probably. six stacks of pumpkins for four stacks of glass is not a bad deal. Okay, yeah, no, they're not loaded. But I can actually check if this over here is loaded. Why was I going to go down in the first place? I forget. Doesn't show the durability if it's at max durability. Interesting. Alright. Alright, I was gonna take some of this. That's where I was gonna head down earlier. I just forgot. Box, I need your assistance again. We're going back. See how much progress we made. Look at all this. All right. Time for a long session of just tree cutting. As it turns out, efficiency 5 netherite, pretty darn good. Thank you. there any, I don't think there's anything extra in there. Should start despawning. Yeah, it's despawning. What is this monster of a tree? I'm gonna have enough oak logs for like the rest of time. Interestingly, I can condense oak logs by crafting them into chests. So I might do that. We've just been chopping down trees for like the entirety of this song. There is logs in there. Large oak trees are the worst. On that hidden log. Thank you.
Ouch.
We just got tree. That's what we got. Honestly, like, I don't even know what to. We're getting close to the end. This carnage. Deforestation, the humane way. I could have just burned it all to the ground. Actually, I have a stack of oak saplings. You know, if I ever get a zombie pigment farm set up, I could literally use golden apples as my main food source. Okay, I should probably stop for now. Let the trees get cleared out a bit. Oh my goodness. But we got ourselves a stack of sticks. What's this? Yeah, I'm feeling good about heading back. Got a lot of birch logs as well. Sticks go in like the main area. That's where they go. Go right here. That's right. Look at that. Two more stacks of sticks. That's cleared up. I want to fly the long way. I just feel like it. I was gonna jump into the lava pool and try and use my trident. I don't think that's how it works. Wait. There we go. Alright, I have both shovels in hand. I don't know why I'm talking like this. That's exciting. Finally reached the second corner. Why is there so much dirt? This song's very nostalgic now. I can see that coming. This song's very nostalgic to me. I mean, it was 2 years ago now. But unlike 21, I think this one actually holds up. One thing I think, Brutal Mode, going back to that after like an hour, one thing I think Brutal Mode has been teaching me is that my theory on Chomper actually being very good is correct. Chomper's biggest problem in the original Plants vs. Zombies was two things. One, the time to eat was like way too slow. And two, it was outclassed by basically everything. But in Brutal Mode, attackers are garbage. Like, they're just straight up bad. Most of the time, letterheads will absolutely demolish any attacker strategy you have. Because most attacker strats are too slow. So, Chomper. Like, attacker strats are also bad against newspaper. So, Chomper, and then you need to do a lot of damage quickly to football zombies. Chomper, you need to kill angry dancers or letterheads. You use Chomper. Need to kill random zombies from a bungee ambush. Chomper, screen doors reflecting your projectiles. Use Chomper. It's just the ultimate solution to every problem. It's just use Chomper. Like, it almost makes you think the developer just didn't test Chomper. I don't know, we'll see though. Zombonis could be a problem. Of course, though, if we get Spike Weed, then Zombodies are no longer a problem. For a second, I thought that was lava. No, it's just my shulker box. almost formed like natural stairs. We just paddled out. My shovel is like dying. Oh yeah, I've been playing a bit of PvZ Heroes recently, just in the off time. And I've come to a few startling conclusions. One of which being, I think the biggest one, and the biggest takeaway I have being that a card that nobody talks about needing to be nerfed, that definitely needs to be nerfed, is Lima Plugludon. Like, that card isn't even fair. Oh, also, Infinity players are carried by luck. Like, if they don't get Con Man turn one into, like, swashbuckler turn two, they lose. Unless they, of course, high roll with powers. But every single infinity is a high roll deck. If they don't get exactly what they need turn one, they just, they're on the back foot the whole game. What's insane is I think Infinity is an awful matchup into heal, which is like meta plant side. So I don't know why everybody runs Infinity. Because the matchup is, again, awful. I've been running an Imp deck with Infinity because I've had to, because the ticket bonus has been on Infinity for like three times in a row now. I'm sick of it. But I've been running an Imp deck, and I've been having a lot of success because nobody is really prepared for Toxic Waste Imp anymore. Like, everybody's playing around Pirate decks, right? Nobody's prepared for the Toxic Waste Imp into Cursed Scargle. It's like, first half of the game, you just run a full Imp deck. You draw cards, you get everything going, and then Gargolith, Surprise Guard, Defensive End, Frankentar. Or not Defensive End. Gas Giant, Frankentar. Frankentar isn't that good in the deck, because if you run it with Gargolith, then it gets reset. But a 5-7 every single turn is not bad. Especially if they're just going to chump block it anyway. It doesn't die to Dragon Fruit, so that's a good thing. But yeah, I've definitely gained a new hatred for Pepper MD. And especially Little Buddy, oh my god. I actually don't think Little Buddy is that broken on its own. I think it just enables so many broken things. And Briar Rose is still really good. People just don't run it anymore because Cobb Cannon is, again, completely broken. Yeah, when I run my Rose Flower deck, Mayflower is, again, a great card for just forcing your opponent to either block it, or you can get a bunch of free cards, and then they have to spend resources on those. Like, every successful shot from a Mayflower is another resource your opponent has to expend. That's why you run it in flower decks and not, like, bean decks. The point of Mayflower is not to synergize with beans or anything, though if it does, that's funny, but it's to give yourself more options and basically say, okay, if you don't remove this Mayflower, I'm going to be playing stuff like Laser Beam, and you're going to have to use Locust Swarm or Rocket Science on that. Or I'm gonna get squashed and absolutely destroy a big minion that you have. A lot of hardy heroes tend to, like, invest in big minions. I have a new hatred for Flag Zombie, by the way. But, how Flag Zombie had never gotten nerfed in the entire history of PvC heroes, like, kinda insane. Because having a turn 2 field of, like, triple Con Man and Flag Zombie is ridiculous. Or triple Middle Manager and Flag Zombie. Or, like, triple Cheese Cutter into Flag Zombie. Even just, like, double Cheese Cutter Flag Zombie is really good. Like, how are you supposed to counter all these free one drops, you know? Alright, I think I'm gonna head back before my shovel dies. Yeah, I definitely think that I've gained an appreciation for a lot of cards in that game. Mayflower is definitely underrated. Snapdragon is one of the best cards in the game. I wholeheartedly think that Snapdragon is one of the best cards in the game. It is slept on so hard. Like, people know it's good, but I don't think they realize how good it is. Toxic Waste Imp is still like an S tier card. Imp Commander's not bad either, especially if you run it with Imposter. Infinity Imp decks go really hard. Gargantuar synergy is what I've been messing around with, specifically like Gargoleth synergy. Probably tell from me mentioning it in the Infinity Imp deck, but the deck I've actually been using most, you might have been able to tell, is a Neptuna Gargantuar deck. Gargolith, Defensive End, Rodeo, and Surprise Guard with Flag and, what's the card called? Gargologist. It's extremely effective. You can, it's kind of insane. You can, like, what is it? Flag on 2 into Gargologist on 3 with a Surprise Guard. Gargologist plus Surprise Guard on 3. And then you can, Gargolith on 4, or Defensive End, or really anything at that point. Gargologist is extremely strong because either people don't run Shamrocket anymore, or if they do run Shamrocket, they run out of Shamrockets, or if they're running Grave Removal, they don't have enough. Because you can block bust, right? But I'm also running Landscaper, so you might just block bust all my Landscapers, and then here comes the Surprise Garg into Gargolith, and then all of a sudden can't deal 6 damage in one turn, so all my Gargantuars are healing. It's like, if you can't stop it while you're ahead, then you're never gonna get, you're never gonna catch up from behind. So I've been, that's been the zombie side. The plant side, of course, has all been burp. I have a new appreciation for Nightcap, because, Pair Paradise and Imitator with burp is really funny. Like, you get 4 Birds of Paradise down at once, your opponent can't do anything. Your hand becomes flooded, it's hilarious. Like, that doesn't happen very often, but when it does, it's so funny. But Nightcap also has access to stuff like Berry Blast. Banana Launcher is really good as a control option, especially against pirates. Like, you can berry blast the, what is it called? The swashbuckler the next turn after, you know, it's played. There's like, oh, my turn 3 flame phase with my swashbuckler, it's a 3-3, you just berry blast the swashbuckler. And you had your banana launcher from before, so now you're just building up banana bombs for the next turn so you can kill their flame phase instantly. It's not even counting anything else you're playing. Sometimes I get sick of it for a bit, but when you get a good game going on PvZ Heroes, it's the feeling is unmatched. I've had Void Stars into Falling into Shadow before on stream, I don't think. I don't think I've ever had this order, like, ever. I don't think I've seen if this minecart is clogged. Thank you. it. I'd like to get my shovel prepared. That would be nice. It would be nice. One thing I would do is keep the stream open. Like, you know, after the time limit goes up, and just, like, AFK. And just leave the stream going with, like, music for a bit. But I can't do that because you'll hear the sounds in the background. So... There's so many iron golems just wandering around over here. At 1,000, or wait, 1,000, 14,000. We got, like, what is it, 20 minutes left? Glass. to clear out literally all of this. Open. We just let all this fall. Honestly, this feels fake. It feels like fake terrain. See, now that part's open, and you can see it. Like, there's visibility. Where are you? Online spaces do I hang out in? Aside from the, TFZ2 Altverse Discord, I don't think I hang out many places. Tennessee? No. First time I've heard that one, actually. Tried to press back and I actually pressed the E key. That always happens when I take damage. This is why you get peaceful pill, ladies and gents.
Some people from Tennessee, I don't know, but I forgot their names.
Hmm. Well, I've never been to Tennessee. Also never met anyone from Tennessee. No clue how you found me? Well, welcome anyway. Yeah, no, I'm a Plants vs. Zombies guy. That's my biggest area by far. Like, I know stuff about other games, but DBZ is like the area I just stick to mostly. Of course, I say that, and then 2 out of 3 of my streams for the week are always Minecraft, but... You're very much not, huh? Interesting, interesting. Have you ever played Plants vs. Zombies? If you haven't, I would recommend it. I think it's like only $2 on Steam, so if you have Steam, yeah. Good game, though. Good game. Have the need to get invested in the game. It's not a very long game, but yeah, no, I understand that. I don't really get committed to new games anymore myself because, you know, all the stuff I already do. Like, in addition to Minecraft, Minecraft alone takes up a lot, but... Yeah. Yeah, no, Time is one of those things you never really get better at dealing with. It's more so you learn how to work around it. But, yeah. That being said, managing time is a valuable skill that I do not have. If you're wondering about the music, by the way, I made all the music on stream. That way, I don't get copyright struck. Looks deep fried? Why? What? Hold on, I gotta pull it up on my phone. Are you kidding me? This always happens. The video seems fine on my end. Encoding thing? Yeah, because it seems to be always not on my end. Like, every time. Every time it's not on my end. Whenever somebody has an issue with the stream, I'm just like, dude, I don't understand. Stream in 4K? Maybe. Yeah, maybe if your device can't handle 4K or something, I don't know. I don't know how streaming works, I just do it. Oh, look at that. That right there, that's some good erasure of area right there. I don't know what words are. But it's fine. It's fine. My ambitious plan to mine out the entire Nether will probably never happen because I have better things to do with my time. If I can mine out like this area around here, that would be good. I don't know. Doing a Twitch constantly makes me wonder about swapping to YouTube, but I never do it just because I've been doing it on Twitch for so long, and I like the some of the stuff Twitch has got going on. I don't actually like the platform. I don't even watch other people stream, but like when it doesn't work, you can feel the frustration. Apparently, mobile is just better for watching streams, I guess. So wait, your phone can support 4K, your phone supports 4K, your computer does not. Makes sense. Thanks. I don't even know who makes computers anymore. How do you even get like deep fried shrimp? How is that a thing? At this rate, I might have to swap to YouTube just because of technical issues. I've literally made it a point multiple times that I don't stream on YouTube for a reason. But, like, it's annoying. Very annoying. If you Twitch, fix the platform, please. I mean, I could, but I don't know if my computer would like that. My computer's pretty good, but, like, I want it to last. I don't want to kill it immediately. Honestly, the whole streaming in 4K thing was a mistake. But I just kept doing it. If I lower the bitrate, it might fix the stream. Just the stupidest thing I've ever had to say in my life, but whatever. You know, Astro, you're just motivating me to, like, try and make a YouTube video out of these streams. I have, like, thousands of hours of footage at this point. I don't even want to go through it. I guess the longer I wait to not do a video, like, the longer the backlog gets. But, man, my backlog's already, like, 2.5 years, at least. Probably 3 at this point. Like, dude. That's not even mentioned... I'm probably never doing this again, but I did a 24-hour stream once for the 100th Minecraft episode. That was earlier this year. I don't want to edit that. I don't want to go through that. Dude. I was probably delirious at the second half. I don't even remember. I save the stream so other people can watch it. And I don't have to think about it. Oh, well. Ow. Alright. Let's get out of here. I don't know why I decided to go to the Nether and start doing stuff, but... well, here I am. Oh. Oh, here we go. The bitrate thing, maybe mobile scales differently than PC. It seems like PC just isn't scaling at all, because if it's going from 4K to deep fried, that just means something's off. Bro, is this gonna be what makes me switch to YouTube? I don't wanna switch to YouTube, dude. Still hitting the browser with 4K resolution. Yeah, so the browser, so your FBI agent can watch the stream in 4K, but you don't get to. That just makes me upset. Okay, now I'm gonna put this in this chest. It's essentially downscale. Why is it downscale? I don't understand. It could have to do with my monitor. I didn't have any brown mushrooms, really? How is that my first brown mushroom? Time played. 15 days. That's my first brown mushroom. Okay. Okay. Either 6 or 8. Well... that might be what's going on. What's funny is that I'm pretty sure in the YouTube videos it shows up fine when I download the streams. So, interesting. I'm probably gonna have to fix that. Well. Kind of fortuitous that happened, that we're having this discussion now, actually, because we're hitting the 3-hour mark, which is the end of the stream. So I can go fix that immediately, because, yeah, somewhere it's downscaling a bit, right? Yeah. Well, thanks for stopping by, Astro. I mean, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, if you're ever just bored, need something to watch, here we go. Yeah. Thanks for sticking around. See you next time. Bye.